There is this box in the middle of the street and this is blocking the traffic. And hence we want to move this. So how can we move this box? Well, we can either push this box or we could pull this box to make it move. So what did we just see? We saw that in order to make the box move or to set the box in motion, we have to either push the box or we have to pull the box. And in physics, this push or a pull is given a special name and it is known as force. So force is a push or a pull. And by applying force, we can make an object move. Now note that not always can you make an object move just by applying force. So for example, if no matter how hard you try to push a wall, you would not be able to make it move. But the converse is true. That is, in order to make an object move, you do need to apply force. We move a lot of things in our day-to-day life. And in order to move them, we apply force. And note, each force can be broken down to a push or a pull. So let us look at some day-to-day activities that we perform. Well, to open or close the door, that is, to move the door, we either push it or we pull it. Again, to make the book move from the bookshelf, we pull the book. To make the cycle move, we push the pedal. And to move the tennis ball, we push the racket onto the tennis ball. Now let us come back to our box. We need to move this box through this door. So from what we've understood so far, in order to make this box move, we need to apply force. Now does it matter in what direction do we apply the force? Say, for example, can I push this box from this side and make it move through this door? Well, no. If I push the box from this side, the box would move in this direction. So in order to make this box move through this door, I need to push the box from this side. So, direction is also very important while defining force. And hence, force is a vector quantity. We need to define both magnitude as well as direction in order to define force. Now, let us notice something. This boy is trying his level best to make this box move by pulling it, but he is unable to do so. Now, boy number two is also trying his level best to make the box move by pulling it. But again, even he is unable to make it move. But notice what happens when both the boys start pulling together in the same direction. The box moves. What can we conclude from this experiment? We noticed that boy one was unable to make the box move by himself. Also, boy two was unable to make the box move by himself. But when both boys 1 and 2 pulled the box together in the same direction, they were able to move the box. Now, how can we relate this to what we have studied so far? We have studied that in order to make an object move, we need to apply force. Also, the magnitude of force is important. So, the magnitude of force applied by boys 1 and 2 individually was not sufficient to make the box move. But when they pulled the box together, the magnitude of the force was sufficient to make the box move. Hence, we can conclude that when two or more forces act on an object in the same direction, the magnitude of the forces add up. Now, what happens when forces act in opposite direction? We had just seen that two boys were able to make this box move when they pulled the box together in the same direction. Now what happens if two more boys start pulling this box in the opposite direction? Will the box move? Well, we see that if two boys are pulling the box from each side, that is from opposite sides, the box does not move. So when equal forces are applied from the opposite sides, equal forces applied from the opposite sides of an object, they cancel out the effect of each other. Why is this so? Well, when one force acts on this side and the other acts on this side, they behave in such a way that the net force is equal to zero. That is, they balance out the effect of each other, and hence such forces are known as balanced forces. Now what happens when the forces on the opposite sides are unequal? Well, as we can see in this case, there is a sumo wrestler on one end and there is a small boy on the other end. Now when they start pulling the box together, obviously the force exerted by the sumo wrestler is greater in magnitude as compared to the force exerted by this boy. And hence, the two forces acting on the opposite sides are unequal. So here, we notice that the sumo wrestler is not only able to move the box, but also the poor boy along with it. So what happened here? Here, the forces applied on the object do not balance or cancel each other out. Why was that so? That was because the force in this direction was much greater than the force in this direction. And hence, the net force was not equal to zero. Such forces are known as unbalanced forces. So what have we studied so far? We have studied that force is a push or a pull, and force can make an object move. Further, when two or more forces act in the same direction, they add up, and when they act in opposite directions, they subtract with each other. When the forces are equal, they subtract such that the net force is equal to zero, and those forces are known as balanced forces. When the forces from the opposite ends are unequal, the net force is not equal to zero, and such forces are known as unbalanced forces.